Hello children, how are you all? I hope you are all fine at your home. I welcome you all for today's session. This is Satyanarayana Kokonda, school assistant English, ZPHS Vinjapalli of Koyda Mandal. I hope you are all enjoying the fun of learning English through online. In today's session, I am here to add some more fun to your learning. Today we learn about homophones. Homophones are the words that are uttered or sounded same but have different meaning and spelling. The word homophone is taken from Greek language. In Greek, the word homo means same and phone means sound or utterance. Now we define the term homophone as follows. A word that sounds the same as another word but differs in spelling and meaning is called homophone. That means we utter or pronounce them in the same way, but they have different spelling and meaning. For example, B-R-A-K-E, break. B-R-E-A-K, break. The pronunciation of the two words, break and break, is same. Now look at their spelling and meaning. The first one, spelling is B-R-A-K-E, break. That means it is a mechanical device which is used to slow or stop something. And the second word, spelling is B-R-E-A-K, break. It means to separate something into pieces. Those two words differ in spelling as well as in meaning but have same pronunciation or same sound, so they are homophones. Children, look at the following list of homophones. All these words have same sound but have different spelling and meaning. Note down these words and use them in sentences with their different meanings. Now we see how homophones confuse us while using them in sentences. For example, Rajesh is going to dash in brackets meet oblique meet his friend. In the example, two homophones meet, M-E-E-T meet and M-E-A-T meet are given. Which is the right option for the blank? Yes, you are right. The first word M-E-E-T meet is the right answer. Now observe the second sentence. Rahul went to market to buy dash. In brackets again, M-E-E-T meat oblique M-E-A-T meat. Children, what is your answer? Very good, children. Here, the second word M-E-A-T meat is the right answer. Though we answered right in the given examples, we have faced some confusion while answering because their sound is same and they appear almost alike. Now we see how to avoid such kind of confusion in using homophones. The first thing we have to do is we should practice using the both words in the same sentence to show their differed meanings. For example, take two words, allowed. A-L-L-O-W-E-D, allowed, means to give permission for someone to do something. A-L-O-U-D, allowed, means making a bigger sound or in a loud way. Now, we use them in the sentence. The children were dash in brackets allowed oblique allowed. To shout dash in brackets allowed oblique allowed in the ground. Children, try to say the answer. Very good. Children, you tried well. In the first blank, A-L-L-O-W-E-D, allowed, is the right answer. And in the second blank, A-L-O-U-D, allowed, is the right answer. The second thing to avoid confusion is, we must practice uttering the words phonetically. For example, emphasize the E sound in council and the I sound in council. Next, we have to link the words with others that we know already. Example, here, oblique, here. The first word, H-E-A-R, here, which means listen, we can link it with ears. And the second word, H-E-R-E, here, can be linked to a place. In this manner, practice using homophones. Children, I hope you have enjoyed the fun of using homophones. Thank you all. Have a great day.